Welcome to Department of Electrical Engineering, RJUKT, Basar. Electrical Circuit Analysis Lab, EE1801. Let us do an experiment number 6, that is verification of superposition theorem. Hello students, let us do an experiment number 6, that is verification of superposition theorem. The aim of the experiment is to verify principle of superposition theorem theoretically and practically. Let us come to the statement of superposition theorem. In any linear bilateral network with multiple sources, the response in any element is equal to sum of individual responses while all other sources are non-operative. So to do this experiment, we need some apparatus like resistor, ammeter, RPS, breadboard and connecting wire. With the help of these apparatus, we are going to verify superposition theorem. So this is the circuit diagram. Here we have three resistors R1, R2, R3 and multiple sources, nothing but V1 and V2. Here we have taken all two voltage sources V1 and V2. So this diagram is both voltage sources are acting, that is V1 and V2 are acting in the circuit. So the second circuit, that is second image, indicates the voltage source V1 is acting alone. So while coming to the first and two figures, here two sources are acting, but here only one source is acting and other source is shorted. So while doing the superposition theorem, so if you want to replace a voltage source, that should be replaced with short circuit and the current source is replaced with open circuit. So here we have both are the voltage sources, so we are making short circuit. Coming to the third figure, voltage source V2 is acting alone and V1 is short circuited. So to verify the superposition theorem, we need to follow a procedure which includes some 5 steps. The first step is connect the circuit as shown in figure 5.1 and note down the current flowing through R3, let it be capital I. And in the second step, connect the circuit as shown in figure 2 and note down the ammeter reading, let it be I1. And in the third step, connect the circuit as shown in 5.3 and note down the ammeter reading, let it be I2. It means that in the first step, what we are doing? In the first step, we are connecting the circuit like this, we are connecting and we are measuring a current flowing through this R3, that is I. And in the second case, we are shorting the voltage source V2 is short circuited and we are measuring a current through the R3, let it be I1. In the third case, the circuit is connected like this. It means that V1 is shorted and only V2 is acting alone, and we are measuring the voltage, that is of current through the R3, that is I2. And we have to verify that in the fourth step, we need to verify I equal to I1 plus I2. It indicates that the total response equal to sum of individual responses. And at the last step, we have to compare practical values with the theoretical values. So this is the tabular column which contains parameters. Parameters are current flowing through the R3 theoretical value, current flowing through the R3 practical values. When both V1 and V2 acting, and when V2 equal to 0 and V1 is not equal to 0, it is nothing but it means that V2 is short circuited and V1 is acting, and in this case V1 is 0 and V2 is non-zero, that is of V1 is short circuited and V2 is acting. And while doing this experiment, we need to take care of precautions, that is of check for proper connections before switching on the supply and make sure of proper color coding of the resistors. The terminals of the resistors should be properly connected. So in the lab experiment, we are going to consider three resistors. This R1 is 470 ohms. We are considering R1 is 470 ohms, R2 is 470 ohms and R3 is 1 kilo ohm. So by taking 470 ohms as a R1, 470 ohms as a R2, and for R3 we are considering 1 kilo ohm. By taking these values, we are going to do the experiment for verification of superposition theorem.
Hello everyone, we are here to verify the superposition theorem. According to superposition theorem, in any linear active bilateral network having more than one source, the response across any element is the sum of the responses obtained from each source considered as separately, and all other sources are replaced by their internal resistance. The superposition theorem is used to solve the network where the two or more sources are present.
So this is a circuit diagram to verify the superposition theorem. So if you observe, in the circuit we have three resistors and two voltage sources. The resistors are 470 ohms, 1 kilo ohm and 470 ohms, and two voltage sources, that is 0 to 30 volts its range, and variable resistor. So this is the circuit diagram to verify the superposition theorem. So in the circuit we have two voltage sources and three resistors, 470 ohms, 1 kilo ohm, 470 ohms. So in obtaining the response across any element, according to the superposition theorem, we need to replace the source with internal resistance. So the internal resistance of a voltage source is 0. So the 0 resistance is replaced with short circuit. This is a line which indicates short circuit line. So here we have replaced a V2 voltage source with a short circuit line in the first case. In the second case, what we have done, we have replaced the first voltage source with internal resistance. That is the first voltage source is replaced with a short circuit line.
So this is a circuit diagram connected on the breadboard to verify the superposition theorem. This is the RPS in order to get the dual regulated power supply. Means we are having two channels. We can generate two sources, V1 from the channel 1 and V2 from channel 2. So this is the dual RPS, means which generates the two voltages. From channel 1 we will get V1 voltage, that is I am applying it 10 volts. And I'm changing the knob to the channel 2. The corresponding knobs are given here. The corresponding voltage I'm changing by using these knobs. I'm giving 10 volts from the channel 1, which is V1. I'm applying here between 470 ohm and 1 kilo ohm. And second channel 2, which is also given, is 10 volts. It shows 10 volts reading. So which is giving to the second side of the circuit. This is the 470 ohm, this is the 1 kilo ohm. So now I am measuring the total current passes through the 1 kilo ohm, which is measured as 8.44 milliamperes. Please note down on the tableau forms.
3.
Here, to verify the superposition theorem, the source V2 is nullified, means I am replacing V2 with its internal resistance. With the help of a connecting wire, I am short circuiting these two nodes. And in this second case, we are measuring the current passes through the 1 kilo ohm resistance, which is measured as 4.24 milliamperes. Means the current passes through the 1 kilo ohm because of first source, means which is V1. So this reading is considered as a I1 current. The source alone, the first source is nullifying. I am replacing second source with the voltage of 10 volts. I'm changing the channel to, it is 10 volts, The first source is replacing with it its internal resistance, means short circuit. Means I am replacing with short circuit with connecting wires, with the help of connecting wires. So now I am measuring the current passes through 1 kilo ohm, which is measured as 4.23 milliamperes. It is because of second voltage source, that is V2. The current is I2, which is 4.23 milliamperes. Here we are getting three currents. First current is total current because of two sources acting. The second current is I1, which is the current because of the V1 source. The third current is I2 because of the source acting along V2. So according to the superposition theorem, the total response is the sum of the individual responses. Means that is I is equal to I1 plus I2. So in order to let us repeat the same experiment with the different voltages. Consider as 20 volts, 30 volts and measure the corresponding current values. We'll verify the superposition theorem.
This is the tabular column we got after doing the lab experiment of superposition theorem. The tabular column is filled with practical values 8.44 milliampere, 4.24 milliamperes and 4.23 milliamperes. This 8.44 milliamperes indicates that when both the sources are acting alone, and this is the current flowing through this R3 resistor, and 4.24 milliamps indicates this is the current flowing through this R3 resistor when V1 is acting alone and V2 is short circuited. And this 4.23 milliamperes is nothing but this is the current which is flowing through this R3 when V1 is 0 and V2 is acting alone. So from the table we can conclude that here I equal to I1 plus I2. So just fill this table with all theoretical values, then we can say that superposition theorem is verified. You can repeat for other values. So these are all the values obtained when 10 volts is applied, like V1 is 10 volts and V2 is 10 volts. You can apply for 20 volts, the values becomes double. Thank you.